So here we are on holiday, lovely sunny Cumbria. And here's the thing, you're ready for a holiday too, and the hoteliers are ready for your booking. How do you make that choice? How do you book? And above all, how do you get the deal you want? We're going to talk about how the market works and the opportunities, and hopefully both hoteliers and guests will find it useful. Everyone says to shop around and read the small print, but here's some online booking characteristics, what we do and why we do it. So number one, picking the hotel. If you're picking from a chain, you're probably using their website or app, and if not, you should be. Otherwise, for private hotels, which size of hotel and what class of hotel do you choose? Well, smaller hotels are often ranked as offering friendly service and thus have better reviews. Be aware that the term family run is a term that is used very loosely and often abused. We came across one family run hotel which was run by a very extended family based on another continent, and they probably never even visited the hotel. These things happen. You visit 10 hotel websites on average before making a choice, so a hotel has a 1 in 10 opportunity to make the killing. Oddly, we mostly visit the home page, which is phenomenal when you think about it. We really only use the website home page to give us a warm, fuzzy feeling that it's the sort of hotel that we want. This is not good for the hotel and not good for you. So hotels must put their best pictures and virtual tours on the homepage, that is, if they have any sense. Even if you are planning to book directly with a hotel, you will use a search engine online, and more than 70% of us use Google search. A virtual tour provides a 360-degree view of the room, and second best are slideshows on that homepage. Silly though it is, most people don't search out the room views on the other pages. So do explore further. Number two, reviews. So you use the reviews, but are they useful? Hotels consider reviews to be immensely important to their business. They are really keen to have positive reviews. And we are very obliging. We lean towards the positive and report lots of positive things. The downside is that a score of 4 out of 5, or 80%, is actually pretty average and not nearly as good as we imagine. Half of travellers won't book a hotel if there are no reviews, so it makes life tricky for new hotels. Reviews are so important to us that a single bad review for an otherwise good hotel can make us discard a hotel from our shortlist. It might just be a one-off problem or a difficult customer. And if a hotel responds to a bad review in a positive manner, then you should consider this favourably. In fact, a review rating often goes up after a kick in the pants. Be wary of large hotels with high ratings. They have more customers and more reviews, and bad reviews can be camouflaged in the statistics. So take a good, hard look at those. It's all back to our tendency to say something nice. But what if the review is about one dodgy facility? So that brings me to hotel facilities. Three, facilities. If a hotel advertises something, then you expect it to be there and functioning. If it's not, then this often results in a bad review. 4-star hotels have relatively the most number of negative reviews. Since they are sometimes struggling with new facilities that the staff don't know about, or they are understaffed for the additional facilities. The upside is that you can get a good deal on a 4-star if the facility in question isn't one you're interested in anyhow. The bottom line is that you can get a good deal and the hotelier can overturn their bad reviews. And then, of course, there's free Wi-Fi. So many hotels still overlook this one. If you're a hotel with free Wi-Fi for your guests, then make a splash about it, since this is the one facility that will convert more guests than any number of swimming pools, hot tubs or spas. Four, methods of booking, or how to save money. First of all, how do you book? One, through a hotel website. Two, directly with a hotel by telephoning them. Three, using an OTA such as a booking.com or TripAdvisor. Or four, through an app if you're booking with a chain such as Premier Inn or Hilton. In general, 60% of bookings are done online, and surprisingly, 36% of us still use a desktop computer to make a booking, although that's coming down all the time. The rest is on mobile and tablet. It varies on whether you're staying in a rural or city hotel. 60% of us would prefer to book direct with a hotel on their website, but we don't because prices for the same deals are cheaper with an OTA. Hotel websites are not mobile friendly and they're not easy or user-friendly to use. The exceptions are chains and their mobile apps. Be particularly careful about the deal you're buying, whether breakfast is included, that sort of thing. It's not always clear and you can be stung. Hotels need to wise up to the fact that they really need to improve their website booking systems and the fact that for 65 to 96% of the time, prices are cheaper on an OTA, which is a complete turn-off from booking on their hotel websites. Hotels should remember that we look them up on Google anyway, away from the OTA. So if you haven't used an OTA before, try one now. Even though hotels are charged for this service, it's still significantly cheaper. On one-night stays, almost two-thirds of us use mobiles or tablets, particularly for same-day bookings. It's worth remembering, if you want to get a good room, a quiet room, try to make it clear up front rather than accepting what you can get. Often you can end up with the least favourable room because it could be all that's left, so check in early, and sometimes they prefer to save the better rooms for the longer staying guests. So that's the bottom line. Shut up. So, in summary, when booking with chains, use their apps or website. Don't be in the 90%. Now, I want to say that again, actually. I'm just put off by this stupid pigeon. So, in summary, when booking with chains, use their apps or website. And don't be in the 90%. Do check out the rest of a hotel's website, not just their homepage. They are trying. Good review ratings can be misleading, and a single bad review for a good hotel can also be misleading. Find the best deal by comparing OTA prices with website prices. And remember, most hoteliers want repeat business and want you back. Most guests want a good time, so you're both on the same side. Have a good holiday, and if you need someone to check out some five-star hotels for you in advance, I'm free.